those animals, you mock those animals, and that's what comes off your people too, you know, the mocking the prophets of the Lord.
Yeah, because this is not a tourist attraction.
Right.
You know what I mean?
America's about to hear America's melting your fucking eyes down here.
What? What? They got some festival going down.
The Jazz Rib Festival.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. It was stacked down yesterday, packed. Man. I was going to that shit. I was thinking in my mind something's going to happen, but I rolled through here, you know, just to see.
That shit's all the way down, all Front Street. And they down there celebrate. They got special events just to eat pork. You know what I mean? The Jazz and Rib Fest. You know that's targeted toward Jake. Because Jake created Jazz. And he's the master of ribs. Of cooking up them pork ribs when the Bible says don't eat.
Yeah, you're right.
And, you know, they'll have a public event where they sanction the cooking of swine's flesh. And everybody enjoys it. They probably making a lot of money off of selling pork down there. Defiling the people.
Swine flesh.
These people is gone out here, man.
Second Chronicles 36:16. But they mocked the messengers of God and despised his words and disused his prophets to the wrath of Yahweh grows against the people.
Like I said, this is too wicked to stir. This ain't nothing but a tourist attraction, you know? Here we're giving you the key to your salvation, but this is a joke. The average bitch just think it's a
joke. Hey, but I bet she don't know she a Jake either. You know what I mean? Yeah, Ginger's walking around, don't know who they are.
Think this is a goddamn tourist attraction. They take it, they think lightly of a warning. They think lightly of the men of the Lord giving you a warning, blowing the trumpet. It means nothing to them, you know? It means absolutely nothing to them. Brother, that motherfucker's a Jake. He got a spirit of Israelite.
He does, don't he?
Yeah, he got a weird spirit. Brother, it is. He is a Jake. He's more than any motherfucker.
But I got something to tell you.
Uh-oh, shit.
Yeah, that's some shit, man. You only gotta pray for brothers, man, you know?
Oh, wow, I got it.
Just gotta pray for them, man.
Hey, you really do, though, because...
I do all the time, man. I pray for all everybody.
We gotta deal with some fucked up shit out here. You know what I mean? Brothers in the truth, they might have wives that... They just totally despise everything they do. Then they go out, you know, fucking everybody behind their back, breaking up their families. And you out here trying to do the work of the Lord and your wife's being a hoe.
Yeah. Hey, you know what I mean? Hey, sometimes fucking everybody in your face.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey, they'll do it right there. Yeah, they don't care. They ain't got no shame, bro.
I guess the woman, since she knows everything about the scripture, skipped over that part of the Bible when it speaks about the spirit of jealousy. You know, when that judgment comes, when that motherfucker sliced their head off, you know.
Yeah, because you see that a lot of times, you know, a dude might, his wife would cheat on him, he'll pour gasoline on her and catch the bitch on fire.
And then you
next thing you know, she's on TV crying, trying to get sympathy where her face is all melted.
Right.
Bitch ain't got a nose, she ain't got no ears. She's still alive. And they gonna lock the dude up in prison like he did something wrong. They say, I can't believe he did such an atrocious act. Like, committing adultery is not atrocious. Like, that's not an abomination. That's punishable by death. You know what I mean?
Have a pity for this
one. I got no pity for none of these hoes. Whenever I hear about one of these hoes getting jacked up, I laugh, bro. I clap. I praise the Lord.
Here we go. This is Leviticus 20:10. And the man that committeth adultery with another man's wife, even he that committeth adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death.
The adulterer and the adulteress shall surely be put to death. So according to the laws of the Bible, if you had a woman that cheated on you with some piece of shit man, according to the laws of the Bible, they're both supposed to get put to death. Okay? Both of them. But you know, these people out here, they have a problem with that. Oh, that's wrong. No, that's not wrong. That's righteous. That way you put sin away from Israel when you do that. You know what I mean? So this is a wicked and adulterous generation. So they got a lot of death sentences that's about to be handed out. You know what I mean? Hey, America done received a death sentence. The whole damn nation's going to be destroyed. You know what I'm saying? This whole country, this land is going to be laid waste. It's going to be laid desolate. Because the Lord's about to rain fire on America. Ain't going to be no more adultery no more then. Ain't going to be no more LGBT gay rights when this whole motherfucker's burning. Going to be no gay parades when your shit's on fire.
That's right. Here you go. This is Numbers 5:29. This is the law of jealousy. When a wife goeth aside to another instead of her husband, yep, and is defiled.
Yeah, because when a woman has sex with someone besides her husband, she's defiled. And then pretty much she's worthless after that point. Her whole body's become defiled. Her spirits become defiled. Go ahead.
That's right. You ain't supposed to be turning into that bitch anyway.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Yo, there's laws on that.
Yep. You going in after another nigga after you nutted all
up in there. Nutted all up in there. Done put some herpes up in there for
right,
you.
Right. Third, or when the spirit of jealousy cometh upon him, and he be jealous over his wife, and shall set the woman before the Lord, and the priest shall execute upon her all his law. Then shall the man be guilty from iniquity, and this woman shall bear her iniquity.
But out here in America, they don't want to give out no punishment to an adulterous woman. Actually, in America, since this is the kingdom of Satan, that the act of adultery is rewarded with child support. Woman could commit adultery, she get child support, EBT, Section 8. She get all kind of rewards. All of her friends be like, oh, you did good. You should have left him a long time ago. Yeah, you made out good. Now you getting paid with his broke ass. That motherfucker ain't have a job no way. Yeah, he ain't shit. That's a wicked spirit that's out here. There's a wicked, demonic, evil spirit of adultery out here. And y'all supposed to call these women out on the adultery too.
The wickedness, you know, not join in on it.
Because back in the old school, back in the old days, if a woman was got caught committing adultery, she was a whore, the whole town, the whole city would shun her and call her a whore. She's the town whore. Stay away from her, you know what I mean? They don't do that now. Now if a woman is a whore, she gets praised, she gets awarded, you know what I mean? She wins awards. The bravest woman of 2016. You know what I mean? You know, they give out a word. Well, actually, the woman of the year last year was Caitlyn Jenner, though. This is a number of freak show out here.
Second Peter 2:14. After eyes full of adultery, that could not cease from sin. God and unstable souls of heart that have exercised the covenants and practices of cursed children.
After hearing the warning, they can't relate to all being judged, you know. Since they never been judged before, they're gonna just continue on with it.
Yeah, that's why you gotta judge them. That's why you gotta say something. You gotta, exactly. Hey, get that can't forget about that one.
Isaiah 58:1. Cry aloud, fear not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet and show my people the transgression.
Cry aloud, spare not. That means don't care. Who cares? Who cares to your young lady or some old hoe?
You treat them all the same.
You know? Right, that's right. You know? Nowadays, these young girls, they know what hoes do. Yeah.
Yeah, because they get pranked by the age 13, 14.
Right.
By the time they're 18, and they got five babies.
Right.
With five different baby daddies.
Mama talk. They mama talk to use the system.
Yeah.
So they can get a welfare check.
Yeah.
They can get food stamps, benefits. Benefits. From being a fucking dope.
And then when they get the food stamp card, they don't feed these babies with the food stamp card. They sell the food stamps.
Yeah,
they sell the food stamps. Then they go buy weed with it. They're going to buy weed with the food stamp money, with the child support money, buying pills. You know what I mean?
Drinks for her and her nigga.
Yeah, they don't, the women, they don't drink no natural ice either. They drink that good shit. They like to get that $40 bottle, $50 a bottle.
Oh, the good weed too.
Yeah, they got to have loud. Yeah.
It's loud.
They ain't smoking no dirt. You know what I mean? So, man, these bitches ain't shit out here, man.
So we out here to tell you.
Yeah, we see what y'all doing. We know what you doing. You gonna tell me the Lord don't see it? That's why he got us out here.
Then I'm laid up, then I go to sleep, wake up, and I'm like, and next thing you know, it's like a half hour show on my
car. I got one. This is Mark 8:34. And we have called the people unto him with his disciples also. He said unto them, whosoever will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. You know, a cross is a heavy burden. And these people, they can't dip them up. The average person can't deal with a heavy burden. You know what I mean? For whosoever will save his life shall lose it. But whosoever shall lose his life for my sake and the gospel, the same shall save him. So most of these people, they love their life. They be on Facebook, ooh, loving life, love my life. I'm so beautiful. You know what I mean? They got the pride of life. But what shall it profit a man if he gain the whole world or lose his soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? This is the point right here. Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh with his Father and the holy angels. So that was that tell you. All these adulterous hoes and these adulterous men, they come up, you know, scoffing at the word of the Most High. They make a joke out the word of the Most High.
Or be a captain saver.
Or be a captain. Are you captain saver hoes? So look, when the Lord comes back out the sky with the angels, y'all gonna get burned up. Y'all gonna get disintegrated. You're not gonna make it. You're not gonna be saved. Okay, you're gonna be destroyed. Totally annihilated.
Hey, that's the faith of the saints.
That is the faith
that's
of the saints.
That's the faith and the patience of the saints.
The faith and the patience of the saints.
You know, they burned the fuck up.
They is gonna get burned up. I think it's a joke. I think it's a game.
You're low down than an adulterous ass motherfucker. That's a low down piece of shit. No.
That's why, but that's all part of the elite's plan too. To break up the families. Because if you break up the family, society's a lot easier to control. Because the man doesn't have his power structure no more. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, break up the family, it's a lot easier to control that woman.
It's way easier to control the woman. They done turned these women loose out here. They like, these women out here are like wild hyenas running loose with rabies. You know what I'm saying? Just acting crazy. Oh yeah, 1 Timothy and 2 chapter. As far as the end of the chapter, we should read it all though. How you doing?
Y'all out here talking about the white devil?
Nah, we out here talking about the wicked here. Because the devil, you know.
Right now we're getting on these adulterous women.
Right, because it ain't the white
spirit
devil.
Of adultery.
He ain't the only devil. You know what I'm saying? There's black devils too.
Yep, and that's what we're focusing on right now.
Hey, what's your nationality?
No, well. She got some white devil in her. She didn't like when we said that something about adultery. behind you, bro.
That dude, man.
What the fuck is that?
I know.
Yeah, she was dope, but hey, she walked around looking like a porn star, bro. That's a good example of how a woman is not supposed to act.
You said that as a thing?
Yeah, most of these women walk around dressed like porn stars, half naked, all their private parts jumping out at you.
You better respect them.
Yeah, we ain't gotta respect these women. You know what I mean? These women are animals. They're like wild. They're like heathens, bro. They're heathens.
Here you go. 1 Timothy 2:10. But which becometh women professing godliness with good works.
Yo, because all these women, they always love to say it too, especially the Israelite woman. Oh, I love God. God loves me. I'm a child of God.
I'm married to Jesus.
Yeah, I'm married to Jesus.
Next time, though, because
you
got
here line up 7 o'clock.
Trying to catch
now, you know the Lord
will
be out of his mind.
What do you want me to do with you?
Let the woman learn the silence of all she
judges. Hey, well, Baal does mean Lord of the Lord, but they do love the Lord. They love Baal.
But I suffer not in order to teach the authority over the man, but to be in silence.
So the Bible says a woman is not supposed to usurp authority over a man, but to be in silence. Okay, we ain't got none of that out here. These women run around all over the place, running their mouth, being loud, being disrespectful towards the men. Y'all always talking shit about her baby's father. You know what I'm saying? Running him in the dirt, saying bad things about him all the time. Man, these women out here is totally out of order. You know what I mean? That's good though. Cause soon the Lord's gonna come back and he's gonna put everybody back in order.
Silence.
Right, he's gonna silence all these women. All these loud, disrespectful women. Yeah, she's talking about she got that wet. Man, the Lord going to smack you.
Man, that wet is pus. That's pus. That's an infection.
Yeah, that's an infection.
Well, Adam was first born, then Eve.
Why they got clinics on every corner? You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Well, Adam was first born, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in transgression.
Yeah, so the woman who was deceived, that's why the serpent in the Garden of Eden went to the woman. He didn't go to the man. The serpent went to the woman because obviously it's easier to deceive a woman than a man. That's why in this society, the government goes to who? They go, because the government's a serpent, and they go to the woman. That's why the government goes to the woman. They get the woman to break up the family. They get the woman to file for child support against the man.
They encourage it.
And they get the woman to wear all these all this clothing that shows their breast and their camel toe. They make all these cosmetic magazines and all them TV shows where they show the women all being like hoes, so all the women who are
all the hip hop house, well, all the housewives shows.
Yeah, all the housewives shows. Essentially, all the movies and TV shows is all adultery propaganda. You know what I mean? Every show, every TV show, every last TV show, every last movie has adultery all through it.
The program, huh?
Yeah, it's a part of the program.
The program. They've been programmed.
They're easy to program, too.
Easy.
Because these people, they're so stupid and they're so foolish, it's easy to manipulate them. It's not a hard thing. You know what I mean?
Notwithstanding, she shall be saved in childbearing if they continue in faith and charity and holiness all she
will write. And ain't none of these hoes acting, coming with a sober spirit, you know what I mean? And the scripture said when they go to church, they're not supposed to be wearing all that costly array with the pearls, you know what I mean? Wearing the gold and the jewelry. But what do you see in the churches? The total opposite of what the scriptures command. They decked out with all the gold, with all the jewelry. They wear extra jewelry on Sunday. You know what I mean? Oh, this is my church jewelry right here. I'm wearing my Sunday's best. Oh, girl, you looking good today. You look tasty.
See, you go to church, you see auditions for casting couch, man.
Pretty much.
You know? You see bitches at church are looking to audition for the glory hole, you know?
the glory hole is when the motherfucker that got a wall and a hole in it, and the nigga stick his dick through the hole. You know what I'm saying? You see bitches at church auditioning for ghetto gaggers. You know? Fucking nasty fucking bitches. Deuteronomy 22 and 22. If a man be found lying with a woman married to an husband, then they shall both of them die.
Die.
Both the man that lay with the woman and the woman. So shalt thou put away evil from Israel.
Yeah, that's why you supposed to put them to death. Well, we ain't gonna put nobody to death, obviously. We ain't got no power. But the Bible says, by you putting them adulterers to death, that puts evil away from Israel. And it puts the fear of the Lord in everybody's heart. And you're gonna think twice about committing adultery after you see motherfuckers get stoned to death.
Yeah, that's what they lack, fear.
Hey, these people got no fear.
2D North High to downtown.
Anybody got some, you got some tape in your bag?
You know what, I might. I got an electrical tape. You don't want no electrical tape. You probably dealing with that, with that triple horn demon.
Somebody got a comfort bro, tell bro, lay them on, man. You ain't the only one laying up with a fucking demon.
What do you think I was dealing with?
Right, right. You know? Don't give a fuck how sweet they act and shit, you know, and cook and clean for them. Them bitches opportunists, man. They opportunists.
If they living in America, hey, they can do whatever they want. They call the cops on you.
Right.
You know what I mean? There's nothing you can do about it. Unless you plan on doing 30.
Right. This is Jeremiah 5:7. How shall I pardon thee for this? Thy children have forsaken me, and sworn by them that are no gods. When I have fed them to the full, they then committed adultery, and assembled themselves by troops in the harlot houses.
Harlot houses. And that's all you got out here is harlot houses. All them churches, all harlot houses. See, even all the regular houses in the neighborhoods is all harlot houses. Whore houses. There's a whore in every house. Hey, the scripture said, who can find a virtuous woman? Her price is far above rubies. That the scripture, the Lord didn't write that scripture just for no reason. Because you ain't going to find no virtuous woman. It ain't going to happen.
I have never seen.
Not in this country, you ain't. All you're going to find is your turn with a hoe. That's all you're going to get. You know what I mean?
You're gonna get
a turn. And really, that's adultery. When you have sex with one of these women that's already been with another man before, you commit adultery when you do that. And then that's a sin unto death on you. I don't care. Oh, she didn't have a boyfriend. If she wasn't a virgin, you committed adultery. That's adultery. Ain't no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
Proverbs 7:11. If both there met him a woman with a tired harlot and subtile heart.
A subtile heart. Yeah, I forgot about this one.
She's loud and stubborn.
She's loud and stubborn. That's talking about these Israelite women, they loud and stubborn. They walk around just yelling at the top of their lungs, being all loud, disrespectful. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Feet not in her house.
Yeah, her feet do not abide in her house. She's always wandering around, wandering the streets, going blowing everybody, getting high with everybody, just being a freak. Go ahead. Club hopping. And no boast about it too, like that was a good thing. They was getting it in. You know what I mean? They was getting it in. They're posting on Facebook. You know what I mean? With their club pictures and all that.
Right, with drinks in
it. Yeah, with the drinks, yeah. Like me and my girls going hard, going ham, or I don't know how they talk now, you know. These bitches are so retarded. Go ahead.
They're talking the same foul as old fucking old man. Ain't nothing changed.
So she caught him and kissed him, but the imprudent bed said unto him, I have peace offered with me this day, have I prayed my vows, therefore come, I forth to meet thee. diligently to seek thy face, and I have found thee. I have decked my bed with coverings of tassels.
Yeah, that sounds like somebody falling for the hokey pokey. You know, he see the beauty and he's falling for it. Got him. That's like got him.
Tapestry.
She said in her mind, got him.
She'll brag about it. She'll boast.
Yeah.
That's why I should have known about me. They'd be like, y'all didn't know about me? You know what I mean? Like, she was, you know, so like, we supposed to know about these raggedy hoes. Like, this raggedy hoe was special or something.
It's a chick from Glass.
Her works, it was fine then in Egypt. I perfumed my bed with myrrh, aloes, and cinnamon. Come, let us take our fill of love until the morning. Let us solace.
She seducing. You know?
That's a succubus.
Himself with love, but the good man is not at home. He's gone a long journey.
That's adultery. Yeah. But they fall for it anyway. He ain't home, so let me get busy and do my thing. Come in.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what's up, man?
With D'Angelo and
Vanguard?
No.
Is that supposed to be a joke?
No. You being serious?
I'm being serious.
Can you tell us who that is?
I don't know. You're listening to it. You're going to love it.
Okay.
What, is it some jazz or something?
No, it's popular music.
He saw you crazy. You're crazy. So.
Popular music?
Are you?
I hate popular music. Popular music's all about adultery.
It's all so crazy.
Help me out here, man. People must be ripping on y'all.
Why you say that? We hope so.
Well, you're coming across kind of.
We hope so. That's why that's how we know we saying and doing the right thing. If they ripping on us.
Yeah, cause they, the Bible calls it scoffing.
Yeah.
Scorners. Scoffers and scorners.
Let me get the scripture on.
All right. Yeah. They like to run your mouth.
Right.
Oh, they're going to like it because I'm on Wi-Fi. Anyway, you're not familiar with.
You got to upgrade your phone.
Yeah,
all that money you got, you can't
only because I'm old. Well, here's the deal. There's a song called A Thousand Deaths, and in it, part of the preaching is from a black minister who's saying, no, Jesus is not white. This is the Jesus of the Bible with hair like lamb's wool. And he lays it out the way it is. And I always wonder when my parents led me into churches, all I saw were portraits of white men, and I thought, this can't be right. I know a little bit of history. I know some geography. So thank you for being doing what you're doing. You're out there. All we can help is civil, peaceful conversation. Everybody gets a pat on the back.
You mean that?
Hell yes, I mean.
Don't you know in the Bible?
What do I mean?
Okay, cause this very book that we out here doing, it's the Lord told us to come out here and prophesy. He's over there. Esau
in
the Bible is going to
slavery.
Esau.
Okay.
I learned from everywhere.
Well, we're prophesying, so it applies now. You know, we're prophesying now.
We're having another
time. That's right.
Although I've had better conversations. I grew up in the 60s in a really rough time in a little industrial town when I was the only white boy in the basketball court. I learned to be humble really quick. But I've had better conversations with the guys I grew up with.
He sent you
40 years. In 40 years, because it had to get really bad to get real good. Now everybody's man. Let's get along.
Ain't nobody getting along. The racial division's gonna get worse. And
I'm getting along with everybody I see.
When the race,
I don't know
when
your
race
problem
rises,
is, but I get along with everybody.
When the race rises,
I wish you well, and I hope. Hope everybody has peace and understanding.
Right.
That ain't gonna happen.
You ever heard of Henry Miller?
The name is familiar. Are we talking about an author from the 60s?
Yeah. What he said. The American white man, not to speak of the Indian, the Negro, or the Mexican, hasn't a ghost of a chance. If he has any talent, he's doomed to have it crushed one way or another.
Where are you getting at?
Oh, I'll be searching for something.
Yeah. Old white guys aren't all bad.
Oh, well, you're right. I agree.
So,
but Edomites are bad.
Give a few of us. Treat us on a one by one. Come on, man. Here we go. Treat us on a one by one, you know.
We're having a good conversation. It's all good.
We definitely are, and I appreciate that. I appreciate you're out here on the positive side of the influence rather than so many people that are running technically down. That makes a world of difference.
What does positive mean?
blessing me. Well, there's I'm gonna put it this way. Everyone get along.
Yeah, I heard the whole message because
I said thank you. You know what's coming? You're doing,
but we're prophets. We're out here to tell you that death and destruction is coming.
There is that. And
that's positive,
I'll
though.
Give you that.
For the kingdom of heaven to come, the kingdom of Satan must die. It must. I didn't want him to walk away feeling good, bro. You know what I mean? I did not want that to happen. Like, okay, bro, you my homie right here. Nah, bro. Come over here with that feel-good spirit. Oh, they want to get along now all of a sudden. Oh, yeah, Job 20. I wish you get Job 20. We ain't heard that in a minute.
Ezekiel 7:25. Destruction coming, and they shall seek peace, and this shall be done.
Your best here, boy, he came up saying, well, we hope we can find a peaceful resolution or whatever bullshit he was. Ain't gonna be no peace. There's nothing but death and destruction coming out here. You see the race riots popping off in all the cities. The cops getting shot. More cops are gonna get shot. It's gonna get worse and worse and worse.
Today, another one got shot in the car somewhere. I didn't
bother. Yeah, a lot of them, they don't even report all of them on the news.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're afraid. But watch, it's gonna get worse and worse out here. Yeah, probably so. Definitely an Israelite.
This is Proverbs 11:21. Go hand, joint in hand. The wicked shall not be unpunished.
Yeah, so we all gonna get together, we're gonna hold hands. And the wicked, they gonna go unpunished, man. They gonna be punished. Yeah, I appreciate y'all being out here.
How you gonna call me to talk to your friend? Yeah,
you're so crazy, man.
Yeah, man, you know what.
Yeah, that dude had to be Esau. He was just too weird, man. Yeah, Jake don't be coming up with no weird ass spirit. That's how we know that there's a distinction between the nations. And the spirits are different. He just got done eating a couple of pork ribs.
Actually, got on the skies on kind of ways. I think it's full of cocaine. But it's going out of things for pain or life or some shit. It's, they can make it into a one hitter. All the cokeheads, he saw a big cokehead too. He just don't get strung out. That motherfucker will pay his bills. It's Jake that gets strung out with his joke. His dudes has got to get along. But the seed of the righteous shall be delivered.
7:20 to Jervis Village and Seymour Avenue.
Oh yeah, I have a scripture. We don't have to do it.
Oh yeah, I got a destruction scripture. That's what's coming, destruction. We ain't out here going blow smoke up your ass and say, oh, the Lord is going to bless everybody. No, he ain't. Actually, there's a very small percentage that's going to be saved. The scriptures say a few shall be saved. A very small few. Everybody else is going to die a painful, horrifying death. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead with it.
Ezekiel 7:16. But they that escape of them shall escape. Shall be on the mountains like doves of the valleys, all of them mourning, everyone for his iniquity. All hands shall be feeble, all knees shall be weak as water. They shall also build themselves with sackcloth and boil. Horror shall cover them, and shame shall be upon all faces, and baldness upon all their heads. They shall cast the silver in the streets, and their gold shall be removed. The silver and their gold shall not be able to deliver them.
So all your money, everybody talking about get money. Well, what you gonna do with that money? When you on fire, your skin's melting, tongue melting away in your mouth, eyeballs melting. Oh, what you gonna do with that EBT card then? With your ATM card?
Michael Jordan's a billionaire.
Yeah.
How's that billion gonna say anything last day?
It's just gonna get burned up.
Right. He gonna lose most of it anyway.
Look, I got a scripture. Jeremiah 17:15. Behold, they say unto me, where is the word of the Lord? Let it come now. Because the people always say, oh, it ain't never going to happen. As for me, I have not hastened from being a pastor to follow thee. Neither have I desired a woeful day thou knowest which came out of my lips was right before thee. Be not a terror unto me, thou art my hope in the day of evil. Let them be confounded. Let them be confounded that persecute me, but let not me be confounded. Let them be dismayed, but let not me be dismayed. Bring upon them the day of evil and destroy them with a double destruction. And so the Lord's going to destroy all the wicked. Everybody out here do wickedly, y'all get destroyed with a double destruction. All these adulterers, you sodomites, y'all going to get burned up. That's what's going to happen. That's the plan. Okay? That's the love of the Lord. That's the love of Jesus. Right.
I got Revelation 18, and I'm going to start at 1. And after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen,
So Babylon the Great is America. So America's going to fall. America is not going to last forever. Everybody think America's going to continue. No, America's about to be destroyed. But the Lord's going to destroy America. It's the kingdom of Satan. Keep going.
And it's become the habitation of devil and the hold of every foul spirit and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
Yep.
No, and that eagle, that's the eagle, that unclean bird.
Yeah, you ain't supposed to be eating eagles. You know what I mean? There's some birds you like, you ain't supposed to eat an eagle. I bet most Jakes, though, given the chance, they'd eat some fried eagle wings. You know they start to.
Vulture.
They would do it too,
you know,
bro.
They eat a possum. An eagle won't be
nothing. Oh, yeah. Well, we met dudes before. He said he'd eat a possum, he'd eat anything. Yeah, from the rooter to the tutor.
Yeah, they already eat the pork.
You can't get no worse than that.
Right.
Once you eat pork, you eat anything.
Yeah.
That's like the worst possible thing you can ever put in your body.
You can sit here and you can take a shit in front of a pig and he'll eat that shit like it's a morsel, man.
He will too.
Like a delicacy, you know?
People eat swine's flesh like it ain't nothing.
Right. If he can talk, he actually shits more.
That's just nasty too.
Swine, man.
Actual swine's flesh. They eat it every day. That's unbelievable. And they wonder why they sick all the time. Oh, my stomach hurts. Oh, really?
That's why I do some chicken.
What's up, homie?
It's the spirit that this is going on this weekend. As in, Swine Fest.
Oh, the Jazz and Swine Fest.
And swine.
You going out to the Jazz and Swine Fest?
And get you a bucket of ribs.
Just get a whole bucket of gristle, pork gristle, pork grease. They slurping. These fat bitches are slurping it down with the crazy straws.
They bite the bone too.
Yeah, that's what pork does to you. You know, when you go to the grocery store.
That's what a lot of it is.
Well, yeah.
It's like, you know, really, if the cow or the chicken is eating properly, it's good.
Yeah. They jacking the cows up, too.
Like
too.
Yeah. Nowadays, they do the cow and chicken.
I should have stayed named like
cow and chicken.
Like that.
You know? Yeah. Like you brought one time, they feed the cow and chicken candy.
But yeah, that's even if like,
that's why when you taste the meat, it tastes funny. You know, I've had real beef before, real beef with grass thing, you know.
They call that organic.
Yeah.
It's like to the point I want to be like certain types of eggs and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, even the vegetables are jacked up.
Because
they take all the corn, they say 80% of the corn is all genetically modified. You know what I mean? Yeah. And the corns and everything is some potato chips.
Modified corn starch, stuff like that.
Yeah, anything that has a...
it's like a form of glucose.
You know about high fructose corn syrup?
Yeah, that's all.
That's in everything. That's all GMO.
Yeah, it's soda and all that stuff.
Plus, a lot of the food now has soy in it. All All soy is all GMO. And it has high levels of estrogen in it. So when men eat a lot of, that's why there's so many homosexuals now. That's one of the reasons.
The government's like putting it in the products.
Yeah, exactly. To make the men more effeminate.
Make them like more population more easy to control.
Yep, exactly. Yep. That's the truth. I mean, you can see it.
Black men became women.
I mean, that's like satanic corruption, man. That's like,
what is this? What is the kingdom of Satan, bro?
I hate this world, man. I hate what society and everybody.
Hey, you in the right spirit.
To what it was before. I mean, what's like 200 years ago? We're supposed to be one nation under God. What is it now?
They didn't tell you what God they was talking about.
Let me read this real quick. Leviticus 11:7. And the swine, though he divided the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean to you.
Because really, the pig is like the sanitation department of the earth.
It's just,
they eat the trash, they keep the earth clean. Just like a catfish keeps the ocean, the rivers clean.
Wasn't it even in biblical scripture how Jesus supposedly cast the demons out?
Yeah, they went into the
swamp.
Go
over the cliff.
Yeah, they
did. And that basically, when the demons were in the swine, and the swine died, because there was like, demons are like spiritual.
Yeah, that's what the world was stepping around.
When they die, then they get automatically sent.
What was that? Somebody saw that was possessed. There was a couple of people saw that was possessed with a bunch of demons, and the demons started talking to the Lord.
Yeah.
It's like,
don't come out, you know, don't come in, you know. He released us. Expel us into those swine over there.
Yeah, at least,
you know?
But when the swine hit the bottom and died,
It's
like,
we don't know exactly how that works, but yeah.
Like, you know,
I can take it to a whole new
level. The swine itself had more common sense than the food. They had common, I never know people from it, so it's just
going to swine. I don't know about how the physical and the spiritual bones.
Of course. We all got spirits. All of our spirits are part of the Most High. You know what I mean? We all pure energy. That's why there's no such thing as death.
You know, death is separation. Spiritual separation.
It's physical death in your body.
Yeah.
Of their flesh shall ye not eat, and their carcass shall ye not touch. They are unclean to you.
Because that he had been often bound with fetters and chains. The chains have been but asunder by him. The fetters broken pieces. He just could any man tame it. Always night and day he was in the mountains. And so he's trying to cut himself to stone.
And he was possessed when he had super strength.
Now you see that in real life, people get super strength. And then spirits on
them. Well, sometimes God gets the spirits.
He does. I'll tell you one.
You're in a bad situation, you're a man of God. And so he will give you strength to get out of that situation.
You've heard of the superhero. You ever heard of the superhero Incredible Hulk?
I know.
Jack Kirby.
David Banner.
But,
my name's David.
What? Well, for real, but the creator's name was Jack Kirby. He said the inspiration for the Incredible Hulk character.
You're not a sound.
What's that?
What you just said?
What?
The creator's name is Jack Kirby.
Oh, well, you know,
they're going to say that.
All right, the creator of the Incredible Hulk, he got the inspiration for that story because he read a newspaper that a woman's child was trapped underneath the car. And out of her desperation, she tried to lift the car up. And she lifted the whole car up by herself and saved her child.
Right. So the Lord gave her a car.
Actually, they mentioned that twice if you watched the movie from like what?
He injected her with a body and she was like,
actually, they say when I was studying, the woman that he interviewed found the strength to save her. But he tried to save his wife and she ended up dying because he couldn't have the strength. And that's why he was obsessed with it.
I see another story. Somebody got a tractor fell on. He picked up a tractor. How you pick up a tractor?
We ain't trying to make it sound like they picked up the car and tractor like this. They just picked it up enough to get whatever out. You know what I'm saying?
That's thousands of pounds.
That's what people make it sound like. You're trying to say they picked it up on their head like a folding boot.
Hey, we're going to be well, in the kingdom, we're going to have super strength. You can read the Old Testament, Samson has superpower.
We'll probably be able to do a lot of stuff we can't even think
of. Right,
we're
going to.
We used to have superpowers. We're going to get them back.
Nobody's being down, man. We can't continuously take that that drug that's drilling it, man. It's just like stress, man. Does stress kill you? Your body can bombard it, drilling it continuously. Your body will break down quickly, man.
Yeah. Don't talk about that.
You're a deteriorating. You see how cats and dogs are super powerful. And they don't live long.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
You know?
Cats be going crazy. They're right, and they got short lives.
Beautiful how they play. Yeah.
That's a good point, though. They pretty much got superpowers.
Well, I mean,
cats
especially are superpowers. I mean, anybody can do certain abilities with their body, you know? It's like extreme balance, or just tennis, health skills, agility, things like that.
It's a
Strength Corinthians 15:53. It says,
Behold, I show you a mystery. You shall not all sleep, but all shall be changed. In a moment, the twinkling of an eye, the last trump, the trump shall sound.
It works in the box.
This is this is Job 39 and 16. She is hardened against her young ones as though they were not hers. Her labor is in vain without fear. Because the Most High hath deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding.
And we get the old.
Hey, she's a prophet. She's a prophet for Baal. She's right though. I disagree.
Because you know she's celebrating Christmas.
She probably just came from Christmas.
You got the swine moving right on through this castle train.
Right.
Probably still smell the swine on her breath.
Mm-hmm. Right, to her teeth, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Probably still sucking out. Crazy, man.
Start
getting down,
dog.
It's crazy. Let me
get
a
whiff.
That's all
that. That's
what I'm for.
Never takes
you. You smell something. Now you'll get a whiff of it.
Shit.
It was dead too, for their mother, and I would not have mercy upon her children, for they be the children of boredom. For their mother have played the harlot. She that conceived them have done shamefully, for she said, I will go after my lovers. That give me bread, my water, my wool, my flax, my oil, my drink.
You can't trust these hoes.
Yeah.
You can't listen to nothing they say. This is what the scripture says about you.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead.
Verse 3.
Forget, we gotta be loud. You gotta sound off like a tribe.
I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ. The head of every woman is a man.
The head of
Christ is God. Every man praying or prophesying having his head covered, the sign on his head. But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered, the sign on her head.
Wait, stop right there, man. You don't see one of these women's head covered.
Not a single one of them.
Not one.
But are they praying or prophesying them?
And if they...
and if you want to play a numbers game,
it was the custom
ratio-wise,
it was a custom of our people for the women to always be covered. Regardless.
Here's what
yeah,
you see the heathen women doing it.
Yeah, the Muslims got them sisters.
The heathen women.
Every woman that prays to the prophesied with her head uncovered dishonors her head. For that is even all one as if she was shorn. For if the woman be not covered, let her also be shorn. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, she had a head or covered.
Yeah, that's good scripture,
especially
though.
Basically, her hair is her cover. That's why I'm
not. Oh, yeah. That's true. Yeah. Because if you're a man, you're not supposed to have long hair. You know what I mean? And that's another way we know this is right here. It's
called.
The Lord didn't have no long hair. Why would the Lord have long hair if the Bible says you're not a man's not supposed to have long hair?
Right. He can do it, though.
That didn't make... No, that's a contradiction right there. So that's how we know the image was called.
Not to cover his head for as much as he is,
oh, you gotta speak up, man. I can't hear
you. You want me to repeat that?
Yeah, you gotta speak up, man. Shout it, man. It says,
you have all boldness.
What's Isaiah 58? You didn't read it?
1 Corinthians 11, verse 7.
Like a trumpet.
I'm not talking to you guys right now.
Like a trumpet.
No, we want everybody here.
Like a trumpet.
They just gotta do it how we do it, bro. When you read them scriptures, you gotta read them with all boldness.
I do my alms in secret to be recorded.
I mean, well, there you go. We're not giving them
Matthew, okay?
We teach them. Hey, get certain to Isaiah again, though. For real, though. We're not getting on you. We're just telling you. The scriptures is designed to be read loudly, like, you know, with all boldness.
They
all
like
that
church without
listen, the church, you know the scriptures. What do the scriptures say where the church is? It's your body. You are the temple. Yeah. You know, right?
All
right,
1 Corinthians chapter 3, 16 and 17. Maybe not the temple.
See, there you go. So this is the temple. Right? Yeah. He got to listen to the scriptures.
Cry aloud. Spare not. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet. And show my people their transgressions, and the house of Jacob, their sins.
So yeah, so when we speak, we gotta speak with authority. You know what I mean? We can't, because you gotta come out bold, and you gotta speak with authority, because we are the authority. You know what I mean? You can't, don't be scared. Don't be worried about what these rats or roaches think about you.
You know what I mean?
All right.
Especially when you're amongst brothers.
Exactly.
But you know what? Fucking going with us, man. It's gonna be a bunch of bees that gonna talk to my ass. It's gonna feel like bees. Shit. There's a bunch of them motherfuckers, and I can't hit all of them. I'm gonna bite a few.
But that's something a lot of young brothers.
That's what I'm saying. I'm gonna bite a chunk out of a few of them.
But that's something a lot of young brothers have struggled with sometimes. They can't. They don't read very loud. But you get in the spirit, and you'll be. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, I got one. Hold up, bro.
Because the scripture said the Lord had a voice of many waters. That's you know what I mean? Is that Revelation 1?
Yeah, that's just true.
But there's many scriptures on that. I'm not just off the top of my dome.
Revelation 1 and 15. And his feet like unto fine brass, as if burnt in a furnace. And his voice as the sound of many waters.
Right, so when the Lord had that Sermon on the Mount, you know, you watch the movies, it'd be like, come gather hither, my children. Girl, he was on the Mount. He was on the Mount. He was speaking to a giant crowd of people. He was blasting those words.
They was in the valley.
Yeah. He was blasting it. You can hear it for 5 miles. You know what I mean?
You ever watch documentaries on whales? I'm sure y'all have. On whales speak so deep. It's so low and deep that it can be heard for miles. The whale's voice, you know?
Man.
Miles. They speak to each other. To 50 miles away, man, they speak to each other, man. Because that whale's voice travels, you know? And they speak back to each other. And they recorded whales with them deep voices speaking back and forth, man.
Isaiah 46. The voice said, cry. And he said, what shall I cry? All flesh and grass, all the gut and williness thereof is a flower of the field.
Look, this is the spirit. I didn't mean to get this scripture right here. I mean, I was about to get Proverbs 9 about a woman, but the spirit shifted. So Proverbs 8. Doth not wisdom cry, and understanding put forth her voice? She standeth in the top of high places, by the way, in the places of the past. She crieth at the gates, at the entry of the city, at the coming in, at the doors. Hey, let me keep going. Unto you, O men, I call, and my voice is to the sons of man. O ye simple, understand wisdom, and ye fools, be ye an understanding heart. Hear, for I will speak of excellent things. And that's why we talking about excellent things. You know what I'm saying? And the opening of my lips shall be right things. For my mouth shall speak truth, and wickedness is an abomination to my lips. All the words of my mouth are in righteousness. There is nothing forward or perverse in them. They are all plain to him that understandeth, and right to them that find knowledge. You know what I mean? Now I'm going to keep going. For wisdom is better than rubies, and all the things that may be desired are not to be compared with. But that was the point, though. You know, the wisdom cries. And just like it's Proverbs 1. You got that?
What you got?
Okay. Jeremiah 2 and 2. Go and cry in the ears of Jerusalem, saying, thus says Yahweh, I remember thee, the kindness of thy youth, the love of thine actions. But thou wouldst have to be goodness in the land of the house.
Actually, a lot of times people come up, we'll be reading so loud and talking so loud. They get mad and offended, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're like, why are you yelling at me?
Yeah, they take offense.
Like, we're just talking normal,
it's
bro.
Like your spirit, like putting your spirit on the spot or something. When actually the spirit works like that.
It does.
You know, that's bad. Hebrew's bad.
But sometimes you get in the spirit, the scriptures sound so good, you want to blast it so loud that everybody on the planet Earth can hear it.
That's, you know? That, we ain't ashamed. It's cool to speak of those that are ashamed of this world. Shame of
people. Yeah, man. Yeah, you gotta come out here. What's that scripture we used to get all the time? Bold as a lion.
Yeah. That's
Proverbs 19, man.
I'm thinking of another one. I'm thinking.
It's been so long since I got that one. That's one of them old school scriptures.
Right, bold. This is Luke 3 and 4. as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah, the prophet, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his path straight.
That's 28. Yeah, so, you know, if John was out there in the wilderness crying, you know what I mean? He's just out there preaching. And there's nothing more fun than doing this, though, man. Yo, life wouldn't be worth living if we couldn't do this. What would be the fucking point? Like you said, you can't earn. You made a statement earlier. You said you hate this world, right?
What it's become based on all the evil that's in it.
You know what I'm saying? That's the scripture that tells you that. That's 2 John 2:15 said, love not the world.
Bear your cross.
Yeah, bear your cross.
God destroyed the world already once by flood. Next time it's not killed by fire, right?
Yep. That's the second death. Read by the second death in Revelation. That's what's coming, that fire. That great fire.
ICBM missiles.
Hey, let's get some fire.
ICBM missiles.
It could not only be that, it could be anything. I mean, there could be an actual space we don't even see.
Plus, you got the chariots of the Lord, too. This may be a combination of things.
It could be a volcano. It could be anything.
But the scriptures tell you all that. The scriptures tell you there's going to be an earthquake that none has ever seen. And the whole earth will fill it. You know what I mean? It tells you about the...
Well, if the earthquake splits deep enough, then it can scoot lava up.
Oh, yeah. So it's going to be all out. That's what hell is. When people talk about hell, that's hell.
It's within the earth.
They got them earthquake machines. That's
all. Oh, they got that too. Plus, there's a lot of things, bro. And none of them are good.
The loops don't get intensified with the earthquake machines. They know what they're doing, man. They already studied and they did... trial runs all over the earth, you know.
Go ahead.
Where does it speak in the Bible? Because I can't find it. I'm searching it. But I can't find where it says something about this. It's not like prophetic language.
I got a scripture, but they don't.
It doesn't.
The U.S. Navy did test the other day with some missiles, letting off bombs. And they say that this is just updated. They said it caused earthquakes in the West Coast.
Oh, yeah. You know, it never said that shit caused tidal waves. They say that the Japan tidal wave was caused by underwater movement. But he has a good question, though. He asked for the scripture in the Bible that talks about profane language. And what does the word profane mean?
It means like...
Where does the word come from? What language is the word profane? That's a Latin word.
It's not right.
The word profane is a Latin word. It comes from a Latin word fanus, or phantom. Which means phantom is the Latin word for temple. So the word profane literally means outside of the temple. So teaching a profane thing would be something that's not acceptable, which means an evil speaking. See, bearing false witness on somebody, that's profanity, okay? Teaching that all nations can be saved, that's profanity. Teaching that... Teaching that Cornelius is an Edomite and is a heathen and a Gentile. That's profanity. Cornelius is an Israelite. You know, all the people you see, all them Greeks in the New Testament, those are all Israelites. You know the Lord only came to save Israel, right? Did you know that? And that's pretty much...
The possibility of, it's like... What about a person's namesake?
I understand
every person's name has a name. So,
well, it does.
It's like, with my name, David, I know my mom might have picked it out in the Bible or something, but...
What about Sharkeisha? What does that mean?
What does that mean that my life has some kind of significance?
I mean, that's a good name to have. A name is a name. It's a good name. The scriptures say it's good to have a good name. But some people have wicked mothers who give their children ridiculous names that have no meaning at all. You know what I mean? So, David means beloved.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right. And that's why I don't believe in shorthanding my name to Dave. Because what does that mean? Instead of beloved.
Everything's not wrong with that.
Like, I believe in proper names.
I got an earthquake.
But then that got nothing to do with what that question I just asked you about Israel. But the Lord, Did you know about
David
Israel?
David was a king of Israel, though.
He's a great. He's an Israelite from the tribe of Judah.
So you get saved. What is it, like 14 generations before Christ?
Yeah.
Yes.
And what tribe was Yahweh tribe from? The one they called Jesus. His name, I don't like saying Jesus. That's not his name. His name's Yahweh Shah. That's wrong. His name's Yahweh Shah. Yeshua, that's the name. That's the fake Jew's name gave us that name. Just like Yahweh. That came from the fake Jew. That's that History Channel name. Okay, that's not right at all. His name's Yahweh
Shah.
Yeah, Yeshua, that they know Yeshua, bro. Trust me, we're the prophets.
He actually spoke was Aramaic, right?
Nah, he spoke Hebrew. What the scriptures tell us that he spoke Hebrew. We get to skip it.
Okay, so where does everybody get it? He speaks Aramaic?
Out, right out their asshole. That's some profanity.
Yeah, it's a dead language.
Actually, Aramaic is a dialect of Hebrew, but the Lord spoke Hebrew.
So Aramaic is a dialect of Hebrew. Technically,
but it is like not. He spoke biblical Hebrew. Okay, listen. Acts 20. Well, I'm sure the Lord can speak whatever language he wants.
Right.
But his primary language, as long as the disciples, was ancient Hebrew, not Aramaic.
Because
Aramaic at that time was the lingua franca. It was the language that everybody spoke. But the Israelites among themselves, they spoke Hebrew. Look, Acts 26. And 14. And when we were all falling to the earth, I heard a voice speaking to me and saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me?
That's Paul speaking.
It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks.
But Paul said he heard in the Hebrew tongue.
That was Yahweh Shai.
Right, so the Lord was speaking to him in Hebrew.
Yep.
He wasn't speaking Yiddish. No?
That's why they got the book of Hebrews, not the book of Aramaic. Right. You know what I mean?
Like a snake or a lizard talking, you know, like a rat snake.
They change Allah to L, Elohim. You know, they tell you that the letter A doesn't make a sound. You ever study Hebrew? So you gotta study the Hebrew. That's how we know for a fact the Lord's name is Yahweh Shai. Because Yeshua, it doesn't make no sense at all. When you know the Hebrew, when you look into it. Plus, the Lord gave us the name, okay, through the Spirit.
I got a little free Exodus 3. Exodus 3 and 13. And Moses said unto the Most High, Yahweh, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, the power of your fathers has sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, what is his name?
What is his name?
What shall I say unto them? And the Most High, Yahweh, said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am and sent me unto you.
Keep going his point.
And the Most High said, moreover, unto Moses, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, the Lord power of your fathers, the power of Abraham, the power of Isaac, and the power of Jacob has sent me unto you.
See, prayer, it said to God, when he says power with God, same thing. So he said the God of Ishmael, Isaac, and Jacob, not Ishmael, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Because Ishmael was Isaac's brother, right? But who got the promise? Not Ishmael, Ishmael's a heathen. The Lord didn't come for no Ishmael, okay? So the Lord is only coming for the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
It's specified,
isn't it? He just read it, right?
Jacob has sent me unto you. This is my name.
Listen, this
forever.
Is
forever. This is my name forever, and this is a memorial to all generations.
So when you look the word, every time you see the word Lord in all capital letters in the Bible, you look it up in the Hebrew, it says Yahweh. It ain't no Yahweh or Yahweh, wherever they be jacking up the word. It's Yahweh. And the son's name is Yahweh Shah. That's the only name you can call on. That's very important. That's very important.
I got that on this one right here. You got something? You got something?
Acts 4 and 12. Neither is there salvation in any other, but there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Yes, Yahweh Shah. It's not Jesus. Not Yeshua. We can't stress that enough, bro, because You can't be calling on the name of Yeshua. Because that's not the Lord's name. We know that's false.
This is Genesis 16, 17 and 8, 19. And the Most High said, Sarah, thy wife, shall bear thee a son indeed. And thou shalt call his name Isaac. And I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant.
For an everlasting covenant with Isaac, not Ishmael. The everlasting covenant never stops, okay? Because the Lord came to save Israel, and that's it.
And with his seed after him.
And with his seed after him, for all everlasting. The Lord don't change. The Lord said he came for Israel, that means he came for Israel.
And as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. Behold, I have blessed him and will make him fruitful and will multiply him exceedingly. 12 princes shall he beget, and I will make him a great nation.
Yeah, today the Ishmael, you know the Ishmaelites are today? They're the Arabs. Over there in Saudi Arabia. But and they know they're Ishmaelites. They know that. Well, and they know who the real Ishmaelites are.
Israelis, the Saudi Arabians,
the Iranians. The Israelis, they do not descend from the ancient Israelites. That's a nation of devils. Hey, get the poster, bro.
But my covenant will I establish with
Israel. Israel is Israel. That's
yeah, they're not Israelites, They know they're not real.
You know what this country of Iraq or where it was?
It's Babylon.
The city of Babylon. Yeah, Baghdad was the city of Babylon. Yeah. It's just under a different name now. And
you see this? The Jews you lose. I'm gonna read you something. You know the book of Revelation? What does it say? This Revelation 2:9. It says, I know that works in tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them which say they are Jews, but are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. So, the so-called Israelis, there's nothing Israeli about them. Okay, there's nothing Jewish about them. They're all Edomites, the devils. Look, this is out of the Jews' own writing, out of the Jewish Encyclopedia. Edom is modern Jew. So, do you know who Edom is? In the Bible. Who is Esau, or the nation of Edom? Do you recall reading about him?
Read about him, he definitely
did. I haven't
read it too often.
I missed that one. Oh, okay. Jacob, you know who Jacob is? You know who Jacob is? Jacob, his name was changed to Israel. He's the father of the 12 tribes of Israel. Okay? Yahweh Shai descends from Jacob. Okay? As did all the prophets. And he was given a promise in the kingdom of heaven. He was the father, the patriarch of the 12 tribes of Israel. And they were given the blessings and the promises. But he had a twin brother named Esau. And Esau is the devil. Oh, it's getting hot, boy. I know it is. All right, then. You go study upon Esau. It says it's getting hot. I'm glad he left, man. We be trying to bring something up, and then he goes to something totally different. I was trying to steer the boat, but he kept grabbing the wheel like,
Right.
He's like, damn, you make us crash into something. He's like, you driving and stuff, and the dude in the back seat just tries to grab the wheel.
Yeah, that's the motherfucker tell you, speed up, go around the corner faster.
That dude's all over the place. He gone.
That's what happens when you put the bottle.
That's why you gotta have teachers, man. You can't just be out there just figuring it out. I got this, I'm gonna figure it out for myself. Now, come on, man. I don't even know what to say after that one. I mean, dude, he seemed like he might be kind of cool, but he was just bugged out, you know? You have that sometimes. You had that a lot of times. All you see is people bugged out of their minds out here.
I got a scripture. Hebrews 5:11, of whom we have many things to say and hard to be uttered, seeing ye are dull of hearing. For when the time ye ought to be teachers, ye have need that one teach you again, which be the first principle of oracles of the Most High.
Right, because you have people come up here trying to teach us like they know something, when they the ones that need taught. They don't know a damn thing, you know what I mean?
And are become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat.
That's funny, like your girl, or this woman came up here earlier saying she was a prophet. These people are crazy, man. Don't know nothing. Don't know near scripture. Don't know nothing about nothing, but she's a prophet. Big time. It's the, that's the spirit of adultery out here. That's all it is. The spirit of Satan. You can feel it. You can feel the spirit of Satan out here, can't you? I just felt the spirit of Satan get a lot stronger. That is weakening. It's weakening. It's weakening.
For everyone that uses milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongeth to them that are full age.
You ain't going to have like no bird brain woman coming out here breaking down Revelation. She'll give you some old wild, crazy, bugged out doctrine. Like these people coming up saying Obama's the Antichrist or some old crazy shit. And they saying the Antichrist is going to come back and he's going to pretend he's Jesus. And they just make up this big elaborate story that ain't nowhere in the scriptures.
Even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil.
Yeah, most of our people, they can't discern the difference between good and evil. They think everything's all good.
There's no difference.
They don't know no difference. And actually, the doctrine of atheism, and the atheists, they teach that the good and evil doesn't even really exist. They'll teach you, the scientists will say good and evil don't exist. It's only a concept in your mind.
That's completely profane.
Yeah, that's what they teach though. And so you got a whole generation of retards growing up believing that. And with every generation, it gets worse and worse. Every generation of men get more effeminate and more effeminate. You know what I mean? It's getting less, more real men out here every day. You notice that? They get more effeminate by the day. More retarded by the day. That's good though. That just means that destruction gotta be, that's why we know it's gotta be a double destruction.
That's not
what it's near. Yeah, it's near.
It's knocking.
It's gotta be there. This can't continue forever like this. That shit will self-implode. It's like that bubble. You gonna only put so much air in that bubble before that motherfucker pops. You know what I mean? Just like you take the little kid's balloon, then the bubble pops and he starts crying because he ain't got a balloon no more. Pops your
balloon. I hate to bust your bubble.
You
feel salty after your bubble get burst.
Well, it's about to get bursted, all right. Just
you
like
know, look, check this out. Go ahead, bro.
Oh, it's some other stuff.
Well, it's bearing witness.
I was just about to go into about, you know, how the economic bubble.
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Oh, for real? Because, you know, Ron Paul, like, dudes like Ron Paul have been saying it for years. Ron Paul, Gerald Celente, what's some other cats? Kaisers. But they've been saying for years about how the economic bubble, and they keep putting more air in, it's going to pop.
Peter Schiff.
Yeah, Peter Schiff.
He's a real good one, too.
Yeah.
And he actually educates you. You watch the video, you learn something.
Yeah. But these dudes, yeah, right, they know what they're talking about. Right?
Rothschild's even put videos up
on the bubble, how the bubble's gonna pop.
Yep. What I was about to say, what happened in Turkey. Turkey is under martial law right now. And what Turkey did, it's just an example of what's coming. They're under martial law, and the leader of Turkey got rid of jobs. He got rid of thousands of public servants.
He shut down private schools.
Private schools, thousands.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's just a precursor of what's coming to America.
And then all of his enemies, he imprisoned them. They said he's raping them. They said they're in there starving this whole, the people who took part in the coup.
Yep.
And how you say his name is Rogan, whatever the hell his name is. They said they're in there raping the soldiers, humiliating them, starving them, beating them.
That's right.
That's gonna come here.
Yeah. So when there's an attack on America, these jobs gonna get shut down, man. A lot of this shit gonna get shut down.
And that's what they doing with that Black Lives Matter thing. Now they starting to say all the black people are all terrorists now. You're terrorists. Because that the whole Black Lives Matter was all set up by the so-called Jew just so he could call you a terrorist.
And they are terrorists.
They are.
You know, these niggas are terrorists.
They really are terrorists.
Go to the hood.
They're terrorize your ass.
Yeah, they are terrorists.
But, I mean, you can see it, though. Like, clear as like they set y'all asses up, bro. Now you all consider terrorists, and now it's cool for white people to be racist again. It's now acceptable. You know what I mean?
It's justified.
They justified it now.
Yeah. And you see that y'all see the picture of Nate with the dude that shot the trans in the face?
Nah.
Nate with the dude holding hands, posing for a picture shit. And shit.
Got him.
You know?
And
that's bad, man.
Because they like to go down there to the Black Lives Matter protest. He likes to bask in his own glory. He likes to get on TV so he can be seen of men. Like, oh, we're down here. We care about the black community. Man, you don't give a shit. You down there trying to sell them some Israelite merchandise. Make a merchandise out of people. He just look at all them protesters as customers. You know what I mean? He's like, this is a bunch of customers. You know what I mean? Ready to fatten his pockets.
Father and thy mother, when thou shouldest mum break in, be not forgetful before them, and so thou by thy custom becoming food.
Oh, read that again, though. That's a good scripture.
Remember thy father and thy mother when thou sittest amongst great men.
Yeah, so when you sit around, you know, other great men, you gotta remember your father and all the great deeds he did. You know what I'm saying? You gotta pay homage to your forefathers. Oh, that's why people be like, oh, why are you always reading out that book? Well, this is the book of our forefathers. And we're gonna keep reading out. We're gonna pay respect to our forefathers. Go ahead.
Be not forgetful before them, so thou by thy custom become a fool.
Yep.
And wish that thou hast not been born, and curse the day of thy nativity. A man that is accustomed to oppress no previous words will never be before all the days of his life. True source of men multiply sin, and the third will bring wrath. A hot mind is as a burning fire, it will never be quenched till it be consumed. A fornicator in the body of his flesh will never cease till he have kindled a fire.
All bread is sweet to a whoremonger. Hey, that's deep right there, though. Think about it.
Deep.
To a whoremonger, I mean, they'll do anything. Any foul, nasty, disgusting act, they're going to do it.
Right, like the power of the Lord.
Like we were just saying, that good and evil doesn't exist in their mind.
Yep. He will not leave off till he die. A man that breaketh wedlock saying thus in his heart, who seeketh me, I am compassed about with darkness, the walls cover me, and nobody seeth me. What need I to fear? The Most High will not remember my sins. Such a man only feareth the eyes of men.
Yeah, that's what people think. They think, oh, the Most High, he don't even see what I'm doing. As long as I appear righteous in the sight of men, that's all that matters.
Right. And no,
actually, that's the least thing that matters.
Right.
Who cares? Because people call, they think we're evil as hell. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But we probably break the least of the laws of anybody.
Exactly. Such a man only feareth the eyes of men, and knoweth not that the eyes of the Lord are 10,000 times brighter than that of the sun, beholding all the ways of men and considering the most sacred parts.
Yeah, so like your boy Nathaniel, the Lord sees you, man. That's why you got people up in your congregation shooting trannies and shit. You know what I mean? Now you get out there like that. Now your camp is forever gonna be known as the Trainee Chasers. They wear on that purple just like Prince. Yeah. Your boy Prince was a little fruity.
Yeah, yeah. He got taken out.
Yeah, I guess the next step. Oh shit! To join IUIC, you gotta start wearing eyeliner next.
What's that? some brothers brought out that they were sending dick pictures or something.
Yeah, I heard about it. I didn't really see the food.
It's been verified. It's been confirmed.
He's sending people dick pics.
Yeah.
Of someone else's dick? I mean, I don't really want to know.
Right.
I heard about it. I didn't really research it because I was just like, wow.
Yep.
I don't really want to get all the information on that one.
He used to dance Vogue back in the day too.
Vogue? Yeah. Said Vogan?
That
Madonna shit?
Yeah, yeah.
He's going to do a Vogue on you.
With the uniform, the tight.
Come on, Vogue.
That tight, shiny shit.
Hey, Madonna, that's even though she's a damn demon. Hey, Madonna's an Israelite, though.
Yeah, that's a chick. Back in the day, she was gorgeous.
Yeah, Madonna's that girl, man.
Hey,
what'd she say? She was a damn hell spawn. She had that song, "I'm a material girl living in a material world." It don't get no more satanic than that. You know what I mean? But you know, but the Lord gonna destroy Madonna. In the kingdom, she gonna wake up righteous. She got children? How many children she got?
I have no idea. I know she got some children.
Wasn't that dude to Jake, the director or something?
I don't know.
I
wonder if the daughter got found spirit.
Oh, does she?
She might be Jake still. But they dwelling on that wicked shit.
Yeah, they around Jews and shit all the time.
Spirit. Yeah, they probably Jake still.
Because, you know, Madonna, she's into the Kabbalah and all that. Yeah. So all that witchcraft.
Same shit the Jews are into.
She's just a dumb bird brain hoe, you know? She ain't nothing special.
Matthew 10.
Remember that video she had with Cesar Borgia, Crying Blood?
Yeah.
That was always my favorite song by her. The like Living Like a Prayer or something.
Yeah,
that's special. That was a good shit.
She did a concert where they did a crucifixion. I think she was going to be a crucified.
Oh, really? I remember my mom wouldn't let me watch the video. She was like, that's blasphemy.